Welcome to Live at 9:15 from St. Chad's Church in Lichfield. It's good to have you with us for this simple half-hour service, which will include our act of remembrance. We meet in the presence of God. We commit ourselves to work in penitence and faith for reconciliation between the nations, that all people may together live in freedom, justice and peace. We pray for all who in bereavement, disability and pain continue to suffer the consequences of fighting and terror. We remember with thanksgiving and sorrow those whose lives in world wars and conflicts past and present have been given and taken away. As we prepare to encounter the Word of God, we hear our hymn, O God, our help in ages past. Night has passed and the day lies open before us. Let us pray with one heart and mind as we rejoiced in the gift of this new day. So may the light of your presence, O God, set our hearts on fire with love for you, now and forever. Amen. Heavenly Lord, you long for the world's salvation. Stir us from apathy. Restrain us from excess and revive in us new hope that all creation will one day be healed. In Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
A reading from Paul's second letter to the Thessalonians. Now we command you, beloved, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, to keep away from believers who are living in idleness and not according to the traditions that they received from us. For you yourselves know how you ought to imitate us. We were not idle when we were with you, and we did not eat anyone's bread without paying for it. But with toil and labour, we worked night and day, so that we might not burden any of you. This was not because we do not have that right, but in order to give you an example to imitate. For even when we were with you, we gave you this command: anyone unwilling to work should not eat. For we hear that some of you are living in idleness, mere busybodies, not doing any work. Now such persons we command and exhort in the Lord Jesus Christ to do their work quietly and to earn their own living. Brothers and sisters, do not be weary in doing what is right. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
What do you do with your poppy after Remembrance Day? Do you throw it away? Do you keep it for next year? Does it languish in a drawer until you come across it in a few months' time? Perhaps you have a particular place to keep it. The poppy, as you know, is a symbol of our remembering of those who have died for our country in the wars of the last century, particularly those who died in the two great world wars. So I want to ask of us the bigger question: what will you do, what will I do, with our remembering after Remembrance Day? Throughout the country, there are many acts of remembrance today and on the actual day, Friday the 11th of November, when there will be celebrations and remembrances. What happens after the 11th of November and the following weeks and the next month and on until next November, when we'll put on a poppy once more? For some people, remembering is more personal than public. With the remembering comes mourning. I expect that there are now few, if any, people alive who mourn a colleague, a friend, a partner, a parent or child from the two world wars of the 20th century. However, there have been skirmishes since then, and people have lost loved ones in these as well. And mourning what happened to someone special is still very much in their minds. Here in Lichfield, we live near to the National Memorial Arboretum. It's a very moving and interesting place to visit, and its presence clearly shows that remembering and mourning for anyone who has died, especially in a time of war, is something you may not switch in and out of with the calendar. We are at more of a distance, sharing in that solidarity of remembering. And while it may not be personal for us, it still matters. How do we remember? And what we do with our remembering matters. What we do on the 11th of November matters. If we just put on our remembering along with our poppies to one side, then we are not remembering the rightly this weekend. Right remembering is about more than setting aside one day in a year to recall the harsh facts and consequences of war. Such consequences as made plain at this time when we consider the war waged by Russia on Ukraine. Remembering rightly is about how we live in the light of those facts and those consequences as individuals, as a community, as a nation. The Old Testament scriptures are mostly written against the background of war and the occupation of the land of the Israelites by foreign powers. To the Israelites, God's call to them to remember their relationship with him and their history was also a call to remember that from what was reckoned as a disaster was a call to work for a different, for a better future. That promise of God for a different, brighter future is for all nations, not just one. God still asks his people to remember. Right remembering, honourable remembering, requires honesty and vision from us. Christians believe in the resurrection of Jesus after his suffering and death on a cross. That belief should bring hope in resurrection, even in the midst of the chaotic destruction of war, when it may be hard to distinguish right from wrong. Sometimes, with the nations involved claiming that God is on their side. In truth, it is hard to make sense out of the ghastly images of war we see on our media these days, from present conflicts and old images from the last century. For some, it is hard to have or keep faith when we see or hear about shocking acts of terrorism, violence and senseless destruction. Yet in all that there is, I believe a God who weeps and has not abandoned us, or any of those who are caught up in war and its consequences. Honesty about our past. These days, you must recall the facts of wars and conflicts past and present, and remember, with sorrow, pride, gratitude, and wonder. Remembering those who have died, whether as a result of war or not, is sacred, and something that is sacred is to be held with respect and honour to God. Behind each fact of war, behind every conflict, as a result of every act of terrorism or violence, is a person. And behind that person is a family, friends, colleagues, a community, a nation that is different because of that individual. In these days, I think God would also say to all people and to the leaders of the nations, as you remember, don't get stuck with the results of war in a way that causes you to forget. To forget that you have to work for that different, brighter future. It was in the hope for that different, brighter future that people often gave their lives through war. God's ultimate promise for us is that God will dwell with us and there will be no more mourning, no more crying, no more pain. We will get out of our cycles of violence, war and hatred. In the teachings of Jesus, there is a different way. As scripture says, now he is God not of the dead, but of the living, for to him all of them are alive. So, the future starts with us. There is no going back, only moving forward. How will we resolve to be after this annual time of national remembering? When you take your poppy from your coat, where it has been these past few weeks, what will you do with it? What will you do with the remembering that it symbolizes? Rather than throwing it away or forgetting all about it, why not put it somewhere where you will see it and let it continue to nudge you to remember all you need to remember and share the vision of peace and better things God calls us to take up in our future. We still have a lot to learn about living with difference and diversity, about building a culture of peace. In the conflicts between nations, which find a faint echo in the conflicts we often feel in our own lives, we are challenged to be honest yet hopeful. Christians are called to search for and show God's healing, trusting in the resurrection to bind the wounds of history, even from the darkest times, so that by our living we will indeed honour as well as remember those who for our tomorrow gave their today. Amen.
A collect for the second Sunday before Advent. Heavenly Father, whose blessed Son was revealed to destroy the works of the devil and to make us the children of God and heirs of eternal life, grant that we, having this hope, may purify ourselves even as he is pure, that when he shall appear in power and great glory, we may be made like him in his eternal and glorious kingdom, where he is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. O God of truth and justice, we hold before you those whose memory we cherish, and those whose names we will never know. Help us to lift our eyes above the torment of this broken world and grant us the grace to pray for those who wish us harm. As we honour the past, may we put our faith in your future, for you are the source of life and hope, now and forever. Amen. They shall grow not old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun, and in the morning, we will remember them. We will remember them. Thank you. When you go home, tell them of us and say, for your tomorrow, we gave our today. Ever-living God, we remember those whom you have gathered from the storm of war into the peace of your presence. May that same peace calm our fears, bring justice to all peoples, and establish harmony among the nations. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. Now the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Gracious Lord, in the Holy Sacrament, you give substance to our hope. Bring us at the last to that fullness of life for which we long. Through Jesus Christ, our Saviour. Amen. May the love of Jesus Christ bring us wholeness. The grace of God the Father grant us peace. The breath of the Holy Spirit instill passion. And the unity between them give us strength in our walk with God this and every day. Amen.
God save us.
It's been good to have you with us for our remembrance service. We hope that this short time of worship has been an opportunity for reflection and meditation and will help you through the week. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord in the name of Christ. Amen.